chirk. I chirk.
You give her the eye. She's gonna kiss your face. Little cat kisses on the eyelash. Cat butterfly interactions. Yep, there she goes. She kisses you. Greetings, human. Spinning Mantis here with Squirt Reynolds, who's kissing a cat.
Mwah.
We are continuing Blues and Bullets. I apologize that last time my laptop battery died and it
so
abruptly cut off. Wait, I think we have to. We should just check these and
these
say
prisoners
the kids were
treated reasonably well, all things considered.
All things considered.
How do you know? Because they were given crayons, duh.
And so we were just walking over here to the washroom
when everything went horribly wrong.
Yes, well, I think things went horribly wrong in this game a while ago.
Ha, true.
Indeed.
Some square-looking towels.
They're still damp.
Uh-oh. Damp towels.
Shalcom powder.
It's from New Orleans. It's the fancy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Quite the contrast with the rest of the room. I'd almost say it was cleaner than my shower at home.
That's sad, Elliot Ness. I suppose that's it.
So I guess you just need to determine that they showered the children before they...
The children. And so we go to here.
Towels that are still damp. Children's shampoo. Someone wanted them to look perfectly. The damp towels, the children's shampoo, and the receipt from a children's clothes shop indicate that they washed and dressed the children before taking them away. I strongly doubt that they washed them just to kill them, so there is reason to believe that Sophia Capone is still alive.
Okay.
So that does seem like that's all there is to discover over there. We made all of our little deductions. We went upstairs in the last episode.
So that's as far back in that room as it went. It was those two sections there.
It seemed like it. Like it was a dead end there. So.
This conversation again.
So you have a sweet tooth?
Yeah.
And that's why they called you the sugar kid?
Alright. What do you want to know?
So we can ask him something different this time. We asked him last time about jail, so we can ask him about
the last fight. Yes, with the shooting too.
I don't know how it happened. I didn't mean to hit him so hard.
He did say that.
I did.
Yeah, I think you
I think we went through all of them.
First of all,
gotcha.
I should have been
letting
him
beat
me.
B-Manson.
But I wasn't in the mood, and I took it out on poor Billy, a white boy who probably had no idea was rigged. You satisfied? Anything else?
No, I will leave you with your dignity, sir.
And your strange seating arrangement.
Yes. I was just saying before we started recording that I did not know or realize that he was actually sitting on Ivankov there. The Squirt pointed that out.
So now where do we go? Oh.
So we already looked at this. This is where I got the code from the...
Right.
Oh, we got a key. So there's something we need to open up with the key.
Well, didn't we open up...
We got a key out of the safe.
Yeah, and you opened up the locker where the kids were being held in.
Okay. This is different.
Blood splattery.
My god, what is this?
Paint. Ooh, dog fight. People fight.
Bloody paw prints. Made by dogs, most likely.
So I wanted to mention that I was thinking about this earlier, and that sheet with all the numbers on it, I think they were weights, and I think they're doing some sort of fighting in here.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the people who don't get bought as slaves, they're forcing to do some gladiator sport, and that's what last night's
the
winner was about.
These prints were fairly new, to judge by the clean outline of the sole.
Barefoot.
thank God it's an adult. Fighting children and dogs. Bloodstains
trampled by the bare feet of at least 4 different people.
So yeah, it looks like it threw a bunch of people in a pit with some dogs.
Gross.
Looks like a scoreboard. Some of the competitors have letters and a number.
There's good old KKK.
But towards the end, there are others that only have a number.
I'm thinking maybe the slaves only have a number at first, and then when they win, they get a name. Hmm. Something like that. That is the scariest March Madness bracket ever.
Yeah.
So Apollo won. Women? Does it winner? Oh, Apollo. Oh, so I could have found that out before and realized that he was 209 pounds, and that's why I put that into the safe. But I guessed right. Anyway.
Ivan Goff said he dreamt of becoming a boxer. Did his dreams come true down here?
What about the dog part?
Dog boxing.
There's more than blood on here. There's chunks of brain.
Ew. Good lord, this game.
Yeah.
The leather's ripped, torn, by teeth.
So this giant brain with big teeth.
Mm-hmm. You have to.
Around somewhere.
You have to punch sometimes.
Right. So that's the boss we're going to have to defeat.
Yeah. He's ugly.
So, look at the hoses right there. How lazy. You don't hose down the blood.
So are you supposed to like follow the blood track to figure, find whatever else you need to find?
I mean, that would make sense, but in this game, not
really. Gore is just part of the...
I think we just have to walk out of here. I don't think that blood track goes anywhere, really.
They don't want you to go walk back out, does it?
Where's the stairs we came in on? Oh my god. Yeah, it's got this weird forced perspective that's a bit jankety.
Okay, so you can't add those clues to anything.
There's back
in. He's alive.
Damn town.
I mean, there's nothing more to figure out on there. We went upstairs. Maybe there is something down here that I missed. I don't know. Just go sit on some
stools.
Yeah, I guess maybe those are chairs for spectators, dictators, fraudtators.
Fraudtators.
Huh.
Nope.
So that looks like a hallway or something.
It's just a light. Yeah, I guess not.
I mean, maybe go back the way we came in?
I guess so.
Did we miss anything in the shower? Yeah. I don't think so.
Just that thing like, oh, it's clean in the mud.
Clean shower. And then we definitely got all of those because it was like 0 of 4 and we marked them all off. And this is just the squalor that the children were living in. We checked that. We checked the bed. We checked the other drawing. We checked this box that had the
underwear in it.
Underwears in it. And his tie is still over his vest.
Damn it. Put him in the pit. Get a dog.
Right?
Punch out his brain.
Crimes against fashion. So, let's walk out the way we came in. It didn't look like there was anywhere else we could go upstairs.
Mm-mm.
Looked like there was another door there, but it wasn't letting me...
Alright, bye!
Yep. See ya.
Have fun reading your book. Nerd.
Yeah, maybe we are supposed to go back here. Thought this is the way we came in.
Guess not. Oh, cool. Dog meat hooks.
Bloody chainsaw.
Please don't have any gross, like, dead dog things. I mean, grosser than is already right now. Oh, shit.
Based on what I got out of Ivankov and these pieces of evidence, I guess he's a human trafficker.
Oh, you think?
Is there evidence that proves Ivankov was trafficking in humans?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe. And
humans?
Dogs. Is that all?
Yeah, so I bet you there's a bunch of stuff we can actually look at in here.
Looks like dog cages.
Mm-hmm. Oh, maybe the numbers were dogs. And they weren't the people, and some of them
were dogs. Marks seem to have been made by teeth, though I can't be sure.
Okay. Made by...
animal fur.
Mm-hmm.
Just a number.
Thanks. More than just a number.
Right.
I think they tried to clean up urine stains with some kind of powerful cleaning product made with ammonia.
Ammonia
fire
plus
with fire.
Ammonia plus ammonia equals superammonia.
Right. Yeah, fight fire with fire. So what am I missing?
Cigarette butts. Thing.
Bullet casings. They probably shot at whatever was in the cage. Sure.
Cause,
new clue. This guy is a horrible asshole.
They invented these less than 20 years ago to make life easier for lumberjacks. I wonder how long it was before the mob was using them for their own ends.
19 and a half.
This is fresh blood, not more than a day old.
And he's a blood
dried
connoisseur.
Blood. Been there a while.
Oh, so he uses a lot. Scratch marks.
Vintage.
For the dogs as well as trying to.
Marks get away. Left by the chainsaw, no doubt.
Oh. New clue. This all seems really grotesque. These were kept to people.
Cross painted by a hand in blood. Was it the prisoner's own hand and their own blood?
So I find the way Sherlock handles these scenes and these investigation scenes is much better.
Sickening
executed.
Smell, revolting stains.
Like you actually have to think and you actually have to look and stuff. Here it just seems like
it points you
a sequence. Oh, and then this one. Oh, and then this one. And they really don't aren't that interesting.
It's just like,
there's still some water and the food hasn't dried out completely. This cage was occupied recently.
Yeah, so Sherlock definitely pulls off the investigation.
I think it says,
and dialogue, everything's so much better.
The owner of the biggest prostitution ring in Santa Esperanza.
Oh, okay. So maybe there was... maybe
K's.
That's who bought
Holy
them.
Holy Christ.
3 K's.
Is he trying
Holy
to
Christ.
Say that this is like some sort of... like we're trying to persecute the bad guys by being horribly disgusting. Are you supposed to go down in the cellar of gross?
I'm sure we are. I think it's just maybe like a body dump or something.
Oh, great. Looking forward to this.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Jesus.
I could really use a hand. I mean, seriously.
That's great. All right,
buddy.
Humans? Yeah, there's hands.
Human bodies, dismembered and piled up like trash.
Oh,
what?
So really?
This game is so stupid.
The cages are labeled with letters. Recent traces of food and drink.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. Shit in a bucket, but hands.
Right.
Shackles.
The right size for wrists and ankles.
Right.
No doubt.
The wrists and ankles that are, like, now in the freaking trash.
The troughs
for
food
and
drink. The buckets for waste prove it. Can I prove that the people held here were sold?
Yeah. Yeah, you can.
The cages are labeled with letters, or names and numbers. According to Ivankov's register, not all his merchandise. The labels on the cages could refer to the customers who buy human merchandise from Ivankov.
That's what I thought.
I base this assumption on the register.
So the KKK was buying some. Oh, that makes even more sinister.
Others are not. What does he do with the ones that are rejected?
He fights them in a pit.
Chewed and stained with blood and body tissue. A metal table on which bodies were mutilated recently.
The daily rounds.
A scoreboard. Like a knockout tournament. Human bodies, dismembered and piled up like trash.
What?
They're saving that one for last somehow.
Table on which cages that let in those dogs.
And they're going to be like, oh, and how did they dispose of them?
Rejected by his customers, Ivankov organizes fights, probably to the death, between prisoners and between prisoners and dogs. Maybe even between prisoners and his own men. What is the fate of those that lose?
Here we go. Cut them up.
Which bodies were mutilated recently? Human bodies, dismembered and piled up like
trash. Right, seems gross. Clear.
We solved the game.
Yay! It's disgusting.
Some of them, while they're still alive, I'd say they've been thrown into the water, but there's no proof.
They're thrown into that pit. All the pieces. Come on.
Already. I thought I'd have time to finish Act 4.
Are you doubting my efficiency as a detective?
That would depend on the quality of your conclusions.
Let me tell you what happened. Yep. So this was the part I was disappointed that was not Bubblehead when I did it to game again. I really wanted this to be Bubblehead.
Ivankov is a human trafficker. He has various customers who make specific requests. Slavers, pimps... God knows what else.
KKK. Elliot Ness, you're no Sherlock.
He kidnaps them and puts them in these cages, shackling them and feeding them like animals until he's ready to complete the order. When he has enough, or maybe when the designated day comes around, his customer comes here and decides which of his catches are satisfactory and which are not. What does he do with the rejects? For many people, this would be a problem, but not for Ivankov. Like a true boxing fan, he organizes fights between the failed candidates. Bloody tournaments, possibly to the death. I'm sure his men place bets, and that the whole sick spectacle, like the Roman circus, helps keep morale high. But, as in the circus, it's not just people that fight. There are animals, too. In these cages, Ivankov kept dogs. He forces the survivors to fight them, wearing boxing gloves, until the dogs tear them apart. And if anyone survives, Ivankov's own men finish the job. This leads us to the next problem. What does Ivankov do with the bodies?
I would just say, like, no, just go ahead and shoot me. I'm not interested in doing that.
One by one, alive even, if they had the bad luck not to die in the arena. And then, I don't know, maybe he throws them over.
Do you have, like, a furnace on the sub?
Maybe if we interrogate him when he wakes up, he can tell us.
Keep the hands around, though.
But that's not what really interests us. What really interests us is what's inside, or what was inside, this container. In recent weeks, Ivankov has kidnapped 9 children for an anonymous client who pays him a fortune for each one of them. The most expensive item of all has been given the initials SC, our Sophia.
She gave him the finger?
Her shoes, kinda looks like it. Found in
there. She's like, yeah, she is.
Today, or possibly
get on you, night, Sophia.
The customer took delivery of the children and paid in full. Before this, Ivankov bought them new clothes and gave them a shower. Why would he do that? Is it to sell them into adoption and wealthy families? I very much doubt it, but I can't figure out another reason. What I do think is that his client doesn't want to leave loose ends. I think he forced him to get rid of the rest of his prisoners.
This game's fucked up.
This is why they organized fights yesterday, dismembered the combatants, and even killed all the dogs.
And then killed themselves, and then sank the stupid ship, and then flooded and exploded at the same time. Game over.
Wound up caught in a time loop until these teenagers found them on an island.
What?
They're old friends. I'm sure Alphonse will be happy to.
Out of the question.
We're bringing
you saw what he buff. Did, Burke. You want to do it again? Want us to lose another witness? Christ, 20 years ago, I let a child murderer slip through my fingers. I won't let that happen again. What if the two cases are related?
Not gonna persuade you, am I?
No.
Okay.
Knock you out.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
He's gonna have to kill you now. Put you in a... So you know who would get cut up by this chainsaw now? You, Elliot Ness, because you just got knocked out. One shot.
You got boring knocked fight. The F out.
Boring fight. Get the dogs.
I have to figure this is the scene to wrap up the episode 2.
Lord, I hope so.
Little epilogue kind of thing.
Wake up, Elliot. Are
we there?
Hey, Jim, no, what's going on?
But from here, we have to go on foot.
Another flashback, yep. Oh, this must be the old case about missing children, because that wasn't even referenced in the first game.
No.
In the first episode.
Been in the car for 2 hours. You're going to tell me why we're here?
Because we need to get there.
Come on, Jim.
Be patient. I told you it's a surprise. I want you to find out for
oh,
yourself.
Oh, is this the her
or
husband?
Don't you like surprises?
Jim Dockers.
I like him. Who doesn't? But what kind of surprise requires you to carry a gun?
The kind where I'm going to shoot
thing
you to
you
come
can do in Santa Esperanza without carrying a gun.
Touché.
Going to show you my dick.
Do as I say and you'll see. Take it from Jim Dockers.
Oh yeah,
because
you're going to take
friend,
it from Jim
right?
Dockers.
Don't let your guard down.
Don't let your guard down, especially with me. Because I know you're screwing
Have
my
you
wife.
Have you heard of the Vodouna cult?
You mean voodoo? The dolls and needles?
The donut cult?
Yes and no. It's different varieties of the same thing. The Vodun religion from East Africa. In Cuba, they call it voodoo. In Haiti, it's voodoo. Santa Esperanza had its own version. A little community that lived in these woods, no more than 200 people, I reckon.
Santeria.
Right. They say practically all of them died. A sort of civil war sparked up by betrayal.
Speaking of betrayal.
Betrayal between friends.
Speaking of. Uh-oh.
Really?
Yeah, let's go there.
What kind of betrayal?
You banged my wife!
The Vodunas place particular importance on a person's name. They chose a name for themselves when they reached adulthood, and they only revealed it to their partners and their descendants.
Is that so?
It is. Legend says that while he was out hunting with his right-hand man, the chief of the Vodunas was attacked by...
Not such a dumb idea. I wish no one knew my name.
Well, for the Vodunas, it wasn't that simple.
This is actually more interesting than the other part of the game.
Yeah, definitely.
Ah,
go for
shit.
The whole gore thing.
Help me with this, Elliot.
And human trafficking and so forth.
He's gonna get all Edgar Allan Poe on him and put him in
One,
here.
Two.
Right, Telltale Heart and things.
They had different names for day-to-day use. Nicknames similar to Indian names.
I wonder when someone's like, I don't know.
That was a gun getting cocked.
Come on. Anyway, while he was out hunting... The chief of the tribe was attacked by a bear.
Aren't you, like, nervous right now, dude? Should be.
A bear? Don't tell me you dragged me into a wood full of bears.
I wasn't joking when I told you not to let your guard down.
Shit.
Yes?
The chief's wounds look fatal, so he confided in his best friend, the best hunter in the tribe, and whispered his true name to him. The hunter left him in the woods, went back to the village, and told the news to the chieftain's wife and children.
Well, that's tough. It's a lot of cojones to give someone that kind of news.
That's why I always take care of it. But I wouldn't pity him.
Sullivan River flows into the Donovan Dam, I think.
I didn't think geography was your department.
Sometimes I like to dabble in things that aren't officially my department.
So I see. According to Viduna law, from the moment the hunter whispered the dead husband's name to the chief's wife, he would take his place.
What sense?
In the eyes of the tribe, he became him. He had to take on his role, fulfill his duties.
Like boning his wife.
His children, and sleep with his wife.
Dun, dun, dun.
Damn. Should be right here.
What?
The sign tells us which way we have to go. Must be hidden in the undergrowth.
Let me look for it.
Okay, I'll cover you.
Since you know what you're looking for. Is that a tent or...
Yeah, there's a tent right here. I'm looking for a sign in the undergrowth.
Luckily that eye will be there to tell you.
Right? You think? Can't access that though. It's like, nope.
Maybe from a different vantage point?
It's gotta be.
He's like, you're so dumb. How are you sleeping with my wife? You can't even, like, look at the sign. Or maybe it's not that. Maybe something on the ground. Some bear traps. Ooh, maybe this was trying to get you to do stuff in a bear trap.
Is that an arm?
Yeah.
Animal attack, no doubt about it.
Keep looking.
Are they just, like, chilling out here? Are they investigating something? I mean, like... What is that all about? There we go.
What kind of hunter abandons his trap when he leaves the woods? One who didn't have any hands to pick it up, I guess.
Okay.
Ooh, something behind you. Oh no, it was just the...
A weird lens flare. That was scary.
Yeah,
yeah,
I was like, there's some weird red elephant behind you.
Okay, so I don't know. There we go.
Huh. This burned out a long time ago. Weeks, I guess.
Alright. I wonder where the piano player's hiding.
And we're looking for a sign when there's an R. I don't know. I just sort of feel like your priorities are kind of effed up.
Oh, now it all makes sense.
Here's the sign.
It's someone's house.
Looks like it was knocked over by a poacher's prey.
Well spotted. Let's go on.
You taking me to a church?
It's never a bad time to confess your sins.
How long is it going to take for you to, like, start being like, okay, he's trying to kill me because I'm doing his wife?
Obviously, there's something stalking them. Whoa!
What's that?
No idea. You are blocking my target. Sorry.
Sorry, I missed you.
I just Dick Cheney'd you.
Yeah, right? Let it go.
It's all right. Just a scratch.
Probably a splinter.
Are we going after whatever it was?
Let's not push our luck. I don't want our story to end up like the Viduna chieftain and the hunter.
Okay, let's go.
And it's daytime.
Been out a while.
Magically, it's daytime.
They built the chapel after the massacre of the Viduna people.
You still haven't told me how that happened.
The hunter became the chief and moved in with his family. It wasn't the first time that kind of thing had happened. But one thing did happen for the first time. The wounds the bear had inflicted on the real chief were less serious than they seemed. A few days later, he came back and claimed what was his. But the hunter wasn't so sure. He was the chieftain now.
Chief's
side? Yes, but the hunter won his new identity by leaving the old chief to his fate.
He betrayed his friend. I agree with you. As did many of the Badunas.
How ironic.
The rest of the village didn't see it that way. The Badunas were split into supporters of the new chief and the old one, and, well, you know how it all ended.
Da-da-da! Are we gonna have, like, a Vertigo ending here, or...?
Right, up to the bell tower.
Elliot, I have a problem. I think Delphine is cheating on me with another man.
Whoa.
Some nights when I lie down next to her in bed, her hair smells of gunpowder.
Gunpowder.
Who regularly handles guns is touching her. Do you have any idea who it could be?
Confess it. Why? Why not?
I'm sorry, Jim. I should have told you before. I don't even know how it started. Jim, please, put the gun down.
No, kill him.
Put it down. You're late.
Young Ivankov?
Are you going to put you into some human trafficking?
Is that the end? I have a feeling that's the end. Nope.
You know why they built this chapel?
We know.
Typical Americans. They find that a bunch of crazies from some wacky religion have killed each other, and they build them a church, huh? As if the dead give a damn about their Christian God.
Jim, what's going on?
I told you, it's a surprise.
Who's going in?
He is.
Me?
Trust me.
Maybe you shouldn't have told him. This is definitely more interesting than the other storyline, though.
Mm-hmm.
More atmospheric. Okay.
Yeah, Beth? You believe in God?
Yeah, although I doubt splashing your face with water has much to do with it.
Pretty.
Someone had some fun at these critters' expense.
Well, not that. That's not what's pretty. You know what I mean. I'm gonna look tough.
Because I'm doing my little dance.
Mary Magdalene. The prostitute who repented and washed the feet of Christ.
Yep, that's her. The Black Madonna. Professional. Okay.
Hey, dude.
I have a gun pointing at your head. I could kill you right now.
Iron.
I'm not surprised. Today is International Point a Gun in My Head Day.
I won't shoot. I'm here to help you.
Yeah?
Look under your knees.
What is this?
To you, just a bunch of scribbles. But to someone who knows what he's looking at, it could be prison bars.
It's like his tax records.
Reading so.
What, he hates reading so much he sees a book as a prison sentence?
Very funny, Ness. Your financial specialist Garrison here, you'll know what to do.
Why are you doing this?
What do you care? I'm serving you Capone's head on a golden plate. Don't ask questions. Just beat it, Ness. The sooner you set Garrison to work, the sooner all this will be over. Gotta hate cops.
Carmine?
Please, no.
Why?
Carmine? Wouldn't it be Carmine?
Capone? No, you're his right-hand man, his chief executioner.
He's lost his mind. He suspects everyone and everything. He has to be stopped. Don't kill me, for my kid's sake.
You remember Don Prescott? 33 years on the force, my first partner. You left his face in such a mess, they had to make him a clay mask so his family could look at him at the funeral.
Capone wanted him dead.
What about Amber Fisher, 15 years old? You held her prisoner for 3 days. She committed suicide only hours before we came to rescue her. I don't need to remind you what you did to her, do I?
Yeah, please don't.
I was following orders.
No. Capone orders you to kill. You improvise. You enjoy it.
You can't do this!
Elliot, don't do it. Kill an unarmed man and it'll haunt you your whole life.
I deserve a trial!
We're cops, not killers!
Jesus, Ness, weren't you?
Control your anger!
Weren't you the most honest man in Santa Esperanza?
Obviously, that'll come back to haunt us.
Go back to Capone. Don't let him suspect a thing. And when I bring him to justice, you'll testify against him.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Ness. Thank you.
Sounds like maybe you should...
Well done.
Not.
I made that mistake
you
once.
Probably should have taken
only
it.
Once. And it still torments me. Let's go.
But on the way back, we're going to have like an awkward talk about how you're banging my wife.
Congratulations, Carmine. Great performance.
Yeah, it's like a setup of some sort.
Don't worry. I'm not going to touch them.
Thank you. Thank you.
I always keep my word.
If Capone finds out what you made me do, he'll kill me.
That won't happen. You have my word.
Thank you.
I guess it's Ivankov, young Ivankov. Yeah, now he has a beard and he's older.
I think Capone is going to need a new right-hand man.
Okay. A lot of extra story here at the end.
Carmine get in touch with you? How did you do it?
Carmine.
Stroke of luck.
Yeah, that is really weird.
Now, all we need to do is be careful. See what Garrison can find.
Jim, about Delphine?
Shut it. First we finish Capone. Then we talk.
Well, I'm glad then that we fessed up. Yes.
Don't tell me your friends let you down again. Lucky you got me, huh? I'm losing my mind.
Looks good. Some files.
Nope. Guess out the door.
It's only logical that Dawkins should abandon you. He just told him you're screwing his wife. Honest and moronic. But what about the others? What will they think of you?
Now it turned into that Layers of Fear game.
Yeah, right? Pretty soon you have like crazy apples being thrown at your head.
Mm-hmm. Straight shot, straight ahead. Don't really have to worry about looking around.
Hopefully.
No. I'm not controlling it.
How come you lose touch with everyone, Ness? It's just that anyone who gets close to you winds up dead. You should try to save her, right? The question is, can you? Do you even want to?
I would hope so.
Alice.
Refusing to help a two-bit thief who walks into your restaurant is one thing. But abandoning a friend in trouble?
No, please, no.
Is that Alice?
No.
Seemingly not.
Maybe Alice is the young cop? Young lady cop? Is this like people taking over a police station? I can't really tell what's going on.
Yeah.
So yeah, when we played the first chapter, we helped out the guy who came in and was going to rob our diner. We gave him some money and told him to leave. When I played in Bobbleheads, I was hard-ass on him. So that's what he was just referring to a second ago. I guess this is our alternate personality, our conscience, our super
because
ego.
Because of the fact that you... What?
The wire was tapped. They broke into my house. Why did you get me mixed up in this?
Alice!
Oh, this must be his family. We let that guy live and he came after our family.
Elliot, this is your fault. Get me out of here.
Yeah, his wife.
Wife and dad, they were killed, right? I don't even remember.
Some.
Oh, that one's not Ryan.
Hall of phones.
Maybe I was too hard on you. Some friends you do help. Like good old Capone. You committed the cardinal sin of messing up this piano. And now to make up for it.
I'm always lateness. I'm a failure.
You pal up with him on condition he leaves the country he's helped to corrupt.
My father asked you to take care of me.
Oh.
Is this how you respect a dead man's wishes?
Here's the young lady cop.
Very good. Man. You've picked your friends.
Elliot, please.
Say goodbye to the others.
Alice, I...
What? I don't even know what this is about.
This is a nightmare. Has to be.
It was sort of implying that maybe the decisions we made in the first episode mean that some people are going to get killed.
Because
but
you messed with his piano or what?
Yeah, we busted up his piano rather than attacking him. back in the past 20 years ago.
And so he came after.
But see, her. I don't think that's real. I mean, I don't. That doesn't make any sense. We're working for Capone. I don't think he would attack
Defeat.
Lady
no,
Cop for any reason, but.
I was followed, Elliot. From the diner. What are you mixed up in?
I see. You were breaking up with your secret sweetheart.
Duffy, no. Not you. Don't
this
worry,
is
Duffy.
Just all of
I'm
his
coming.
Fears, but I don't know why mm-hmm. this is happening now in the game. It's like more Silent Hill-ish. I just can't help but. Oh, we're actually moving now.
You'll never learn, Elliot. You'll go on putting all the people you love in danger, won't you? Until you're completely alone.
So it looks like as we're walking forward, it's building this path out of the pieces. Someone really wanted to be a movie director.
Right.
Oh, God. Delphine, no. Oh.
I thought she hung herself.
What are you going to do when you're done crying? Now you don't even have the option of getting drunk.
Oh, you still have that option.
You're a failure.
Tell you something.
He didn't even have the cojones to finish off his goon in the church. I doubt you'll be able to deal with the real problem.
You're a failure. The only thing you ever did right was put me away. How'd you do it, huh? How? Tell me.
That's the spirit, Elliot. I'm sure this God you believe in your own way approves of strength, right?
Die.
That's right. Yes, kill me.
Die!
You know which part of yourself you're killing, don't you?
Die! Die! Die!
Die! Die!
Die!
Die!
Die! Die! And then wakes up and he's like, choking his pillow.
He's like, why do I have a giant boner?
Ew.
You know, just choking the old Capone. You know, choking the bald mobster. That's what I'm going to call it from now on. Yeah, I was just choking the bald mobster.
Ew. Oh, my word. Mm-hmm. Oh, my word.
Yeah.
Okay, then. Well.
Die.
Whoa. God, I fell asleep in the porn theater again.
Alphonse is taking care of that.
You knocked me out. You betrayed me.
Betrayed you? Since when were we partners?
Oh, where?
But.
What's going on up there?
That? I think it's modern art. Those things are supposed to be the pillars of Titus Andronicus's palace.
Oh.
He's going to kill him.
Yeah, most likely. Says here, this is the Shakespearean tragedy that has the most deaths in it.
Talk, you bastard! I don't...
I'd say Capone is Titus, and Ivankov is Aaron, who ordered the kidnapping, rape, and mutilation of Titus's daughter, Lavinia. What do you think?
You son of a bitch! Talk! You...
wrong!
We can't let him kill him before he confesses.
I'm sorry, buddy, but what we can't do is to interfere in Alphonse's plans.
Who is Alphonse again?
Al Capone.
Remember what he did to Burke? In five minutes' time, Ivan
Capone. Alphonse. Your brother Alphonse will never
find his granddaughter.
Right.
His prison lover.
What was that?
He's
Come
gonna
on,
get stop.
You'll need help.
You're gonna stop him from killing the guy.
Let me explain. Take a rest. Al, I didn't do a thing. This is all a mistake, I swear.
Just kidnapped and sold your niece.
Are you sure? Because what I found in your submarine makes me think otherwise.
What the fuck did you find?
A lot of nasty shit. Cages.
You keep a register full of names. The names of people you sold to the Ku Klux Klan, to pimps like Abdulkader, or to slave traders.
Alright, yes. I make people disappear. You don't know how hard it was to survive after you went away. Santa Esperanza went crazy. The cops, the judges, the other families. They all wanted to destroy your empire. I had to make a living.
What about the children?
What children? I never kidnapped a child. Never.
I found a box of children's clothing, as well as a big receipt from a children's store. How many kids do you have, anyway?
Yes! For Christ's sake, yes!
Okay, yes, I do.
Children too. Fuck!
I'll kill you.
But I never kidnapped your granddaughter, Al. Your family is my family.
I have a
family.
Feeling he's gonna get kicked through the glass and go flying.
In one of the cages, we found a girl's shoe. A white ballet shoe with daisies.
Okay, fuck yes.
Yes,
but
it's a lie. It's a lie. He's a fucking cop. How can you believe him?
Oh.
That was a ballet slipper in my pocket.
Take it easy, Alphonse. Take it easy.
I need a name. Just one name.
Yeah.
Who asked for the girl?
You're a rat, so I'm out.
Who?
I don't know. I truly don't know.
Back up.
You're right, Nikolai. I'm a fucking cop. But despite my reputation, I'm not a good cop.
Duh. And what the fuck are you going to do with me?
I put together a file on you years ago when you were working for Capone. You left a family behind in Russia, used to send them money. Are your parents still alive? I'm sure your brother is. And his three kids. Or has he had more?
You're bluffing.
Wanna take a trip to Russia, sugar kid?
I never heard a kid scream in Russian, my friend. I've never seen her. She told me to find 9 kids for her not long after Al went into the slammer. Not just any 9 kids. They were all the sons of criminals. Corrupt cops, murderers, rapists.
A woman?
She set up a meet in the caves at Rockford, in the darkness. I never saw her face. A week ago, she had me meet her again. The same place, the same assignment, just like 20 years ago. But with new kids. Including Sophia Capone.
What else?
That's it.
There has to be more.
Maybe there's someone else who does business with her. Back in the day, I had a mole working undercover with the gravediggers' men.
You mean Elaine Ganella?
We were all spying on each other. We had to slice up the cake that Al had left behind. few days after the assignment, Gonella took care of the bodies of 8 kids.
Oh, dear God, not again. Did Gonella tell you why?
Gnaeus?
This son of a bitch was behind the case that ended my career 20 years ago. The missing children were murdered. Why? Tell me why, you son of a bitch. Did she tell you?
No. Why should she? I don't usually fraternize with the competition. That is all. I am dead.
Pretty much.
You have no idea.
You said that.
Screw everything I said.
I don't know what you think I did, but I... Yeah, there you go, pussy. You don't have the guts to do shit.
Like Capone's not gonna tear him apart now?
I knew it was too much for someone like you.
Oh.
Oh yeah, that dude.
Do something! No, please, no!
Did you rip his head off?
I thought that was his.
He doesn't feel pain.
He's too strong.
Because you're gonna help a lot. You can't even stand up.
All that A-mashing and he's still halfway up. Awful lot of pointy things on the stage here. Oh, I was gonna Game of Thrones me. Nope. He's tickling him.
That's so cute. There you go, son.
Where's your gun?
Lost it. Where's yours?
I prefer not to use it.
That's the noise it was making.
Nelson!
But it's gonna be like a horror movie. It's gonna be like, ah.
He seems like a voodoo guy to me. Like maybe
I was thinking. He was like one of those.
Voodanas.
Where do you buy those things?
He wasn't his bodyguard, he was his jailer.
Oh.
You know.
Okay. That's different. So
just walking along stage.
Bye.
Speaking of which.
Yeah.
Let's go. If that thing found us, there'll be more on the way.
All right. I'll go by the suite to pick up my things.
As I lumber slowly towards
right.
The exit.
Oh my.
Change of plan. I don't want my things anymore.
Where is Mr. Capone? Where is he?
There's no one by that name here, sir.
Hope they don't just like shoot us.
We have to help them.
What? That's suicidal. There's too many of them. And only Ness is carrying a gun.
Hmm. So that's going to be the end of this episode. We got to end it here. Maybe the next episode will only be 5 minutes long. That's cool, but we will post that next week.
I have a feeling it won't be.
I know, right?
You're like, it's going to be 5 to 10 minutes. An hour later, some like trippy dream sequences and some memory flashbacks with the jilted best friend's wife's lover's thing and some voodoo crap and all sorts of weirdness.
Anyway, that's going to be all for now. See ya!